Hello and welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. We are in part 36 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 67 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 68. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant that contains three global administrators named admin1, admin2 and admin3. The tenant is associated to an Azure subscription. Access control for the subscription is configured as shown in the access control exhibit. So this is the exhibit where it is shown. So we have to make sense of this, that admin3 user is the owner of subscription. This is what this snapshot suggests. So we can from this exhibit we can understand that admin3 is the full owner rights, have full owner rights on subscription. Let's move the next part of the question. So we'll scroll down and we can see you sign into Azure portal as admin1 and configure the tenant as shown in the tenant exhibit. So what we have configured here is administrator 1, that will little bit scroll down, and yes, now it is making sense. Exhibit we can see that the permissions for admin 1 is elevated, and now you can see here the admin 1 the permissions are having elevated permissions here, since it is the press is green one. And why would we need to elevate the access level here? We need to understand that if global administrator, there are some advantage if we increase or elevate the permission for that. They can gain the access to Azure subscription or management group when a user have any, you know, lost access. Second advantage is that we can grant another user or ourself access to Azure subscription or management group in this case if we elevate the permission. Third advantage is we can see all the Azure subscription or management groups in the organization. So if we elevate this permission, these are the advantages. And also one more advantage is we can allow the automation app to access all Azure subscriptions or management group as well. So these are the, so we can make sense here that admin 1 is having elevated permission, and from the previous snapshot we know that admin 3 is having owner permission on subscription. So let's scroll down and we can go to answer area here. Answer area, where the statement 1, admin 1 can add admin 2 as owner of subscription. Since we know from the exhibit 2 that admin 1 has elevated permissions for the subscription, therefore definitely admin 1 can add admin 2 as the owner of subscription. So the answer for statement 1 is yes. For statement 2, that admin 3 can add admin 2 as owner of the subscription, again admin 3 is the owner of subscription from the exhibit 1. So therefore admin 3 has the rights to elevate or provide permissions or role of owner to subscription to other users. Therefore admin 3 can definitely can add admin 2 as the owner, and the answer is yes for this statement. And third statement is the admin 2 can create resource group in the subscription. That we have to check from the Azure, because these both were, both the answers were straightforward, because here we can see the admin 1 has elevated permissions and admin 3 is having the owner permissions. Therefore they can easily manage the users of subscription. But here admin 2, nothing much information is passed except that the admin 2 is only the global administrator. And if we can manage the resource group in subscription or not, we have to look into. We are in Azure portal and we'll go to Active Directory, we'll go to Users, and we'll go to Admin 2, and we can see here Admin 2 role assigned, and it's a global administrator. So now we will log in as admin 2 and look into it. So let's go. Now we are logged in as admin 2 in Azure. Now we will see here our subscription. We cannot see any subscription. Let's try creating resource group. So we'll go to resource group. We cannot create any resource group. Still we are the global administrator here, but we cannot do anything here. Therefore, for this statement, admin 2 can create the resource group in subscription. We found that we cannot create any resource group in this subscription. But yes, definitely, maybe you might have a question in mind that why a global administrator cannot create any resource group in this subscription. The reason is that to create the resource group in Azure, the global admin will need to have an owner or contributor role assigned to the subscription. Then only it can create any resource or resource group in this. So that is the one requirement when we do have a global admin on the subscription. Definitely it is either having an owner role or contributor role associated with that account, then only it can create any resource or resource group in that subscription. I hope this video was informative for you. Please like, subscribe and press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.